Next, we come to the nature of management. Okay. Nature of management. Okay. Now, management is old as civilization. Okay. Management existed then also. Okay. But now modern management, you have some principles. Earlier it was carried on through rules and regulations. Now modern organizations, the management is through scientific principles adopted by the theorist. So these principles are adopted in the organization to carry on their process, activities, and achieve the organizational goals. Now here we come across a question that whether management is an art, science, or a profession, okay, or whether management is both science or art. So let us start with that. Whether management is an art or a science. Okay. So let us go through the art. What is exactly art? Let us examine the features of art. Okay. How management can be called as an art? So art as a subject, what is it? Art is the skillful and personal application of existing theoretical knowledge. When you understand about art, okay, what is it? When you say art subject is full of theory. We don't have much of practicals there. So art is the skillful and personal application of existing theoretical knowledge to get the desired result. Okay. So it is art, skillful application, personalized application of existing theoretical knowledge. Okay. So art is something you're acting, some act is taking place there. Now, this can be acquired by observations or by experience. Okay. So this art, this skill or talent can be acquired by observation, by analysis, study, and experience. Now let us come to the features of art. Why management is an art? Okay. Let us come to the features of art. So first point we have, it is the existence or existing of theoretical knowledge. Okay. Then it is personalized application. Personalized application. Then you have, it is based on practice and experience. Okay. So management can be called as an art because it involves these features: existence. Okay. Existence of theoretical knowledge, personalized application, it is based on practice and experience. So art is a subject where it is theory based. Okay. You have the theory there, theoretical knowledge is there, okay, you have to apply that. So application is done by each individual. You have the theory given. So experts in respect areas, they have given theory in the form of literature. Literature on dance, on music. You have this on acting, but it depends upon the individual how they take up and apply. So it is a theoretical knowledge, art, existence of theoretical knowledge. How we can connect this to management? How can we connect this to management? In management also, we have the theorist giving the principles, okay? In the books of management, we have the scientific principles, we have the general principles. Theoretical knowledge is available. That theoretical knowledge have to be applied. Okay? When you apply it, then the management, the organization will be able to achieve its goal. So existing of theoretical knowledge, management, we can refer to it as an art. In management also, we have these theories. Next, personalized application. Having theory, studying theory is not sufficient. Okay, we have to apply that. For example, in accountancy, we have the rules, fundamental rules. We know the rules classified into 5 types of accounts. Knowing the rules is not sufficient. We should know how it has to be applied to different types of accounts. Same way, here in management, knowing the theory, knowing the principle is not sufficient. We have to apply it. Personalized application. The class is taken up to all the students, same class. Same lecturer takes up the class. But when then a student is evaluated through examination, there are different marks secured by different students. Why? Because that is the personal application. Each individual's grasping, each individual's understanding, reproducing that is different. So understanding of theory and applying that, there will be difference in the application methods, adopting and getting the result. So personal application, art is a personal application. Simultaneously in management also, the managers have the ready principles given. They have to apply that in order to get the work done, in order to execute the plan which is framed by the top level management. So they have to deal with their subordinates. They have to take up these principles, see which principle is apt to the situation, and then achieve the organizational goals. That is called as personal application. Finally, it is based on practice and experience. Okay. So here art is based on practice and experience. Practice makes man perfect. Learning through experience also makes man perfect. So if you are a dancer, if you want to be a good perfect in dancing, perfectionist, then you have to practice. Okay? If you want to go to compete some competitions, then you have to practice. Practice makes you perfect. Or learn through the experiences, learn through your mistakes what you have committed. That is learning through experience. So art is based on practice and experience. Similarly, the principles which are derived, okay, it is not derived overnight. Okay, they have observed it, they have learned through their experiences, then they have formulated these principles, and these principles are followed by the managers in the organization. The managers learn through their experiences and adopt those formulas, maybe those plans, maybe when they are dealing with the subordinates. So management, we can say it is an art because it is based on practice and experience. You learn from your experiences dealing with the subordinates, dealing with the top level management. Okay? So here, this substantiates that management is an art. The features are existence of theoretical knowledge, personalized application, it is based on practice and experience. So the last one is, it is based on practice and creativity. So as I have told, art involves creative practice. Okay? So it is skillful application. Now, for example, you have a musician. In order to compose a music, you should be aware of the notes. So, being aware of the note is theoretical. Application of that is creativity. As I've told, students, you study in the class, you listen to the lecturer, but in the examination, what you produce, the answers will be different. Different marks you will get. Same way, here, musician, he has the notes, that is theory. When he composes the music, it will be different. Okay? So, composition of music is creativity. Okay? So, there is creativity in using the notes, that is theory. So, musician, when he is composing notes, there is creativity. Composing a music, there is creativity in him. So, here, management is also in the same manner. When the manager deals, he deals skillfully with the subordinates. Taking up a situation, he analyzes the situations. He studies that situation and then he applies the scientific methods there, scientific principles. So we can say management is an art, it is based on practice and creativity. Now we see whether management is a science. Okay? So management as science. The features are, it's a systemized body of knowledge. It is the principles based on experimentation, then universal validity. Okay, so management as a science. What is science now? When you speak about science, science is a systemized body of knowledge which explains certain truths or certain operations of general laws. So, it is explaining certain truth, that is through experiment. So, it is called as a systemized body of knowledge. Science subject, when you say like arts, it is theory based, you say science, when you say it is practical. Practical knowledge, there is observation, experimentation, all this. So, that is what? It is a systemized body of knowledge where you have experimentation, observation. So, in business also, systemized body of knowledge means you have a relation, cause and effect relationship. There is some effect because of, due to some cause. So, this is due to an experiment. When there are experimentation taking place, you come to the end result because of a particular cause. So, in business also, you have this cause and effect relationship. If you have to come to a particular solution, there should be some cause for that. Some problems created, some cause for this problem, and later you come at the solution. So, manager deals with it. So, in management also, you have this scientific application of the principles where you solve the different situations. So, it is a systemized body of knowledge. You cannot just like that apply some principles, apply some rules, apply some laws. In science, as you have laws and principle, same way in business also, in management also, you have scientific principles of management, then you have general principles. So, there are two theorists, you have Fayol and Taylor, they have these principles given. That principle should be adopted. So, we can say management is also a systemized body of knowledge. Next you have, it is principles based on experimentation. So, scientific principles are first developed anywhere. When you develop these principles, they are first observed and then only later adopted. So, these principles are not adopted or advocated overnight. You have to observe it. Okay, then later on you develop it and adopt it, advocate it. So in the same manner, the scientific principles also in management have been studied through the course period of time, not overnight, and then they are given as a principles. So they are based on experimentation. You experiment first, you observe, you take up the experiment, you analyze the situation, then only you adopt it as a principles of management. Next, finally, you have universal validity. Universal is, you can apply this to all situations, to all conditions, universal validity. In management also, these scientific principles have universal application. Okay. You have these planning, you have organizing. So as I've told, science is based on experimentation. Management also is based on some experimentation. Management deals with human beings and human behavior. You know, there are individuals coming from different background. Each individual behavior is different. So when a manager deals, he cannot deal similarly in the same manner with all the individuals. So we cannot say management is a science. It is a science, but not an exact science, since it is dealing with human being, human behavior changes. So it is an inexact science due to human resources involved there. Okay. Next, we come to universal validity. Okay. So scientific principles have universal application. Same way, management also universal applications of the principles. You have to apply to different situations, but the manager should be aware what is the principle he is applying to that particular condition or to that particular situation. So even management, as I've told you, have the features there. Universal applicability. Okay, all pervasive. That is what management has got, universal validity, or it is applicable to all situations in the organization, provided the manager has understood what is the situation and how he has to go about it. Now finally, we have to conclude whether it is a science or an art. Okay, we say management is a science or art. The answer is management is both, and art as well as science. Okay, management is art as well as science. Why it is art? Because it is, there is, we say art because we have the theory application. Practice of management is art. We can conclude by saying practice of management is art, and application of principles of management is science. Okay. So this is practice. Practice is theoretical knowledge. So practice of management is art. Application of those principles is called as science. So we can conclude by saying management is both science as well as art. Okay, both have to go hand in hand. So by seeing these features, we conclude saying that management is both art as well as science. It is art, why? Because we have theoretical knowledge, that is practice. When you're practicing, practice of management is art, your act act is involved there. When you are applying the principles, science is full of principle laws, so application of principle is science. So we conclude saying the answer to the question whether management is art or science, management is both an art as well as science. So before concluding, we have to give the features why it is art, why it is science, then you have to relate it to management. This question, management is art or a science, it may be asked as an 8 marks concept question. So then you have to first give the meaning of what is art, give the features of art connected to management. Likewise, science, management is a science. What is science? Systemized body of knowledge. You give the features, 3 features there, connected to management. Finally, you give the conclusion that management is art as well as science.